In Belgium, the coronavirus crisis is deepening. All bars and restaurants are closing for a month as infections double every week. Belgium follows France in imposing a nightly curfew, and doctors have warned of a shortage of intensive care beds within weeks. The German Chancellor prays for her government's handling of the first wave of infections, told Germans to prepare for hard days ahead, as the number of cases there rises steadily.
Ich weiß, das klingt nicht nur hart.
I ask you to refrain from any trip that is not absolutely necessary, from any celebration that is not absolutely necessary. I know that this not only sounds tough, but in individual cases it is a severe sacrifice. But we only have to do this temporarily, and we ultimately do it for ourselves.
Infections are soaring across Europe, with around 100,000 new cases a day. And the continent's power brokers seem increasingly powerless. On Saturday, the Austrian Foreign Minister Alexander Schallenberg confirmed he tested positive for the virus, raising fears an EU meeting he'd attended on Monday may have been a so-called super spreader event. The Belgian Foreign Minister's also gone into isolation with suspected symptoms. It comes a day after three EU leaders, including the Prime Minister of Finland, were forced to drop out of a Brussels summit as a precautionary measure. Most future meetings will now happen remotely. More than half of England's now under tougher COVID-19 rules. In London and other areas, a ban on households mixing inside, including bars and restaurants, came into force on Saturday as the capital moves from being at moderate risk to high risk in the government's three-tier system. The county of Lancashire in the northwest moves to the top tier, very high risk, meaning no socialising outside a household bubble and the closure of bars and restaurants. But the mayor of Manchester, the UK's third largest city, is resisting the toughest restrictions, warning of dismal consequences for the local economy.
The new restrictions are all part of the government's localised response in dealing with the rising infection rate, designed, said the Prime Minister Boris Johnson, to avoid the misery of a full national lockdown. But given that 28 million people, half the country, are facing these new restrictions, for many it's already beginning to feel like one. Niamh Barker, Al Jazeera, London.